discussing about the laminate code, how to represent the laminates. So I hope you have understood these things. So now let's look at some of the special types of laminates. So the first one is called a symmetric laminate. So what do you mean by symmetric laminate? Means for every ply above the laminate midplane, there is an identical ply an equal distance below the midplane. Okay, so what is the meaning of this? You have a symmetric laminate. Okay, so an example of this can be 0, 45, 90. So this is a symmetric laminate. Okay, so next is balanced laminate. For every ply at a plus theta orientation, there is another ply at minus theta orientation somewhere in the laminate. So what is the meaning of this? Suppose you have 30, 45, minus 30, okay, minus 45. This is a balanced laminate. Okay, for every plus theta orientation, there is another ply at minus theta orientation somewhere in the laminate. Okay, so another example can be say 60, 30, 90, and then 60, 30, 45, say, okay, then minus 30, minus 60, and minus 45. Okay, so this is a balanced laminate. It need not be in a particular order. Okay, so all it needs is for every ply at a plus theta orientation, there is another ply at minus theta orientation somewhere in the laminate. Okay, somewhere in the laminate. So anywhere it can be. Plus theta, plus 30 is there, so minus 30 is there. Plus 60 is there, so minus 60 is there. You have a plus 45, you have a minus 45. So this becomes a balanced laminate. Okay. Next is a cross ply laminate of having either 0 or 90 degree plies. Okay. The whole laminate is made up of either 0 degrees or 90 degree or a combination of this. No other ply orientations. Okay. Quasi isotropic we'll discuss later. So you have understood symmetric, balanced, and cross ply. Any doubts in these three? Any doubts?
No.
Okay.
So that minus theta means how will it be? How will it look like?
Cross ply once again, sir.
Yeah. What is minus theta? Okay.
How will it look like, sir?
Yeah, I'll tell you. So always, what is theta? That's the first thing you should understand. Okay, so we discussed this. You have this x and y axis. This is x axis. This is y axis. Okay, you have a UD lamina, and this is the angle of orientation, say. Okay, so this will be one perpendicular to this would be two. Okay, so what will be theta? Theta will be with respect to x, this is theta. Okay, this is theta. Now, if this is minus theta, what will be the case?
Should it be opposite?
Yeah, the fibers will be aligned in the opposite direction. If this is theta, then minus theta will be this side, correct?
Yes, sir.
So that is minus theta.
Yes.
Okay, always theta means the angle between the direction of fiber and the x-axis. X-axis. Okay, so this is what our convention is. Okay, so this is what we mean by theta, and minus theta is comes down. Okay, so one, this one will be in that direction.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is what minus theta means. Any other doubts?
The cross play once again, sir.
Cross play, you have a combination of 0 and 90 degrees. Whatever laminate you use, 0, 90, 90, 0, 90, 0, or these combinations. Okay, so okay, you make a laminate of having only 0 and 90, then it is a cross play laminate. Okay, balanced laminate, a plus theta orientation, there is another minus theta orientation somewhere in the laminate. Symmetric, you already know.
Yes.
Quasi isotropic, I'm not discussing now. We'll discuss later. These three, you should know. Okay. Any doubts in this? Okay. Now, so we need to discuss about macro mechanics. Macro mechanics of a laminate. Okay. Macro mechanics of a laminate. We have discussed lamina. So this is the discussion of macro mechanics of a laminate. So here, there are some derivations over here. So at the undergraduate level, it's not necessary to do those derivations. So since laminate is little slightly complex, I'm avoiding the derivations. Okay. So, but I'll tell you the details, the brief details, which is whatever is required for this. Now, what are the things that you analyze and get from this? You decide, you want to design the laminate. Okay. You design the laminate. You design laminate means what? You design laminate means what? You decide on the orientation. Okay. You decide on the orientation of the place. Okay. Of the orientation of the ply. And then the number of plies. Orientation of the plies, actually, number of plies. Okay, thickness of each ply, thickness of, what do you mean by ply? The lamina. Okay, ply means lamina. Thickness of each ply. Then just a second. Okay, thickness of each ply, and then what else you decide? You decide the material properties. Okay, what fiber to use, what matrix to use. Okay, what are the other things that you can do? Orientation, number of plies, thickness of each ply, fiber, matrix. Okay. So what you're doing is you're making it tailor-made. Okay. Tailor-made. The composite laminate is tailor-made. How do you make this in suppose if you are talking about isotropic materials, how do you tailor-make? What do you mean tailor-made here?
Custom-made, sir.
Yeah. Custom made as per the requirement. Okay. As per requirement. What is the requirement? What requirements are we talking about here?
So according to the application, sir.
Yeah, the kind of loads that is going to act on the material. Okay. So that is a requirement. Now, if suppose you're talking about isotropic materials, Do you have this custom made thing in that? How can you make custom made isotropic materials? Yes. You have metals, right? Metals.
Yes, sir.
How do you customize that?
My machining process.
Machining. I'm talking about
the. Based on the techniques that we use for cooling of the metal and all, if we change that, the properties of the metal change.
Cooling.
Quenching and then.
Based on the heating process, sir. Okay. Different types of heating methods. We will.
Okay.
Annealing, then quenching, all of that.
Okay. Annealing, okay. Quenching.
Heat treatments. Heat treatments.
Yes, heat, yes, treatments. Heat treatments.
Okay. Okay. But before that, you can decide on the material also. You can alloy them.
Yes. Alloy composition, sir.
Alloy.
Varying alloy compositions, you can get the required properties. If you are still not getting, you can go for heat treatment and so on.
And also about their properties. Except alloys, many other properties.
Yeah. Correct. Okay. So these are some of the ways how you do it in the
metals.
Metals. Okay. Fine. Okay, Manish, there is some background noise. Can you mute yourself? Yeah. Thank you. We have this tailor-made in composites by selecting the orientation of the plies, the number of plies, thickness of each ply, the fiber and the matrix. So this is how you make custom made as per the requirement. Now, I'll just go to some topic which is called as ABD matrix. Okay. I'll explain this. Now you select a laminate. Okay, you select. You select a laminate. Okay, and then calculate. Then calculate A, B and D matrix. Okay, I'll tell you what it is. This is the steps. So A matrix has A11, A12, A16, A21, A22, A26. I'll explain these things. A61, A62, and A66. Okay. And then B matrix, you have the same thing with B11, B12, B16, B21, B22. B26, B61, B62, B66, okay, and then you have the D matrix. How to calculate this matrix, we will see a little later. D11, D12, D16, D21, D22, D26, D61, D62, D66. Okay, these are the three matrix you need to calculate for any laminate. Okay, for any laminate you need to calculate these three matrix. How to calculate, what is the formula, and those things we'll see a little later, but we'll try to understand what is the significance of these three. Okay, A matrix tells us about the extension shear coupling. extension, shear, coupling. So what do you mean by coupling? Extension, shear, coupling means if you apply extensional stresses, it will undergo extensional strains as well as shear strains. Okay, the laminate, I'm talking about the laminate now. Okay, previously we were discussing about lamina, now we are talking about laminate. A matrix will talk about the extension shear coupling, meaning if you have extensional stresses, then it will also have extensional strains and shear strains. Okay, so whether it will have or not, this A matrix will tell. B matrix will talk about bending, extension, coupling. Bending, extension, coupling. So what is the meaning of this is, suppose you have some bending stresses, then the laminate not only bends, but also extends. Okay. In the reverse, if you say, if the laminate is has some extensional stresses, it will undergo bending also. Okay. So bending, extension, coupling. D matrix talks about bending, twist coupling. Bending, twist coupling. Okay. So what is the meaning of this? Suppose you have some bending stresses in the laminate also twists. Okay. The laminate also twists. Suppose the reverse of that is, if the laminate is twisted, it will also bend. Okay. So D matrix talks about that. Now, is this good or bad? Are these effects good or bad? What do you think?
Good.
Anybody saying it's bad?
Bad, sir.
Why?
This is bad, right, sir.
Why it's bad?
Because? For extension, we are getting shear, bending and twist and all, sir. But okay. It must not be there.
It must not be there. Okay. Someone said good. Can somebody explain what is that? Who said good? Someone said good.
So maybe because it is accounting for two kinds of deformation in a single matrix in a way, so you don't have to do it separately. In the same one, you are accounting for both extension and shear.
Okay. So I'll explain this now. It has both advantages and disadvantages. Okay. First, we'll talk about disadvantage. Disadvantages, you have designed the laminate to withstand, say, I'm talking about extension shear coupling, for example. The laminate is designed for taking extensional loads. Okay. And what happens in actual is, when you have extensional loads, it experiences extensional stresses as well as shear. Okay. There is shear strain seen. Then the material is not designed for that. Okay. The material is not designed for withstanding shear stresses, but it's designed for extensional stresses, then it's a disadvantage. Okay. It's not designed to take that load, but the load is not applied, but there is a deformation there. Okay. It's not designed for that. And bending, extension, coupling, also the same thing. Okay. If you are designed for that, to withstand that kind of coupling, it's fine. Suppose you have designed only for that particular kind of load and there is another kind of deformation which is happening, then there is a problem. Okay, that's a problem. Now, where do you see it as an advantage? Advantage, as he said, the advantage is One advantage I'd like to share, just a second. So are you able to see this? What are you seeing? Aeroelasticity.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in this, if you see the wings, the fiber angles dominating bending behavior of both wing surfaces, bending up causes twisting towards the leading edge. Just yeah, so fiber angles dominating bending behavior of both wing surfaces, bending up causes twisting towards the leading edge. Okay, so what it means is when there is bending of the wing surface, there is also twisting happening. So this is what, which is the matrix which is going to talk about this? It is the D matrix. Okay, so what is the advantage that you're getting is when there is winds, okay, when there is winds, there is the this wing bends as well as twists. Okay, when there is twisting, the it'll be able to take more loads. Okay, so it'll be able to take the more loads. So as you can read here, as aerodynamic lift forces the wing tips to bend upward, the forward swept wing wants to twist to higher angles of attack, but the inherent bend twist coupling of the composite laminates forces the wing to twist in the opposite direction and thereby counters an increase in the angle of attack. Okay, so this is what happens, and when this happens, it is increasing the it is improving the aerodynamics of the wings. Okay, so basically, if I generally in one statement, if I have to say, it is improving the aerodynamics of the wings. Okay, so because of this bend twist coupling effect, so this is an advantage. Is an example of an efficient autonomous and passivated activity control system. So here you see, use the bend twist coupling capability of composite laminates. This capability is an example of elastic tailoring and remains one of the most under exploited advantages of composite materials. So this is one of the advantage when it comes to the kind of aerodynamic behavior you want in the wings. Suppose if there is bending and there is also a coupling of twisting, then this will improve the aerodynamics of the wings. So that is what they say, and this will reduce the loads on that and it will help. Okay, so this is one advantage what you can think of when it comes to coupling effect in the composites. So this is one advantage. Disadvantages are many. Disadvantages are like you don't want that effect. Okay, disadvantages, you don't want that coupling to be there. If I have extensional stresses, I want only extensional strains. I don't want shear strains. Okay, if I apply bending loads, it should only bend, it should not twist. Okay, so those kinds of requirements are also there. These kinds of requirements are also there. This is an advantage here. Okay, this is an advantage, but there are some cases where it is a disadvantage. Okay, so here what you do, you intentionally induce the coupling. Okay, in this advantage case, what you do, you intentionally induce, you make sure that there is coupling. Okay, you make sure that there is coupling, but in applications where you don't want, okay, in applications where you don't want, you have to remove that coupling effect. Okay, you have to remove that coupling effect. For that, what we need to do, let's see. Okay, so here for the A matrix, okay, for the A matrix to avoid this extension shear coupling, what you need to look at is the only the A16 and A26 should be equal to zero. Okay, here in this matrix, this term and this term must be zero. Okay, this term and this term is zero means also this term is zero because A16 is equal to A61 and A26 is equal to A62. Okay, these terms must be zero. If these are non-zeros, then it means there is extension shear coupling. Okay, extension shear coupling is there in a laminate if A16 and A26 is not zero. If A16 and A26 is zero, no coupling means no bending extension coupling. Okay, no coupling means no bending extension coupling.
Extension shear, no sir.
Bending.
I'm sorry. No extension shear coupling. I'm sorry for that. Okay, no coupling means no extension shear coupling. If B matrix is zero, what do you mean by B matrix is zero?
Bending and tension.
All the elements, B11, B12, B16, B21, B22, B26, B61, B62, B66, all elements must be zero. Okay, to call a matrix as zero. Okay, then no bending extension
coupling.
Okay, no bending extension coupling.
Sir, if one of the element is also non-zero in the B, then there will be a bending extension coupling.
Yes. Okay. D16 and D26, D matrix I'm talking about, should be zero for no bend twist coupling. No bend twist coupling. How to find this A matrix, B matrix, D matrix, we'll discuss in maybe next class, okay? But I want you to understand the importance of this, okay? So how do you say no extension shear coupling is there? If A16 and A26 is zero, then there is no extension shear coupling. If B matrix is zero, meaning all elements in B matrix are zero, then there is no bending extension coupling, okay? If D16 and D26 is zero, then no bend twist coupling. Okay. Suppose in that aircraft we saw the wings. Okay. We wanted the bend twist coupling. Then what you should do? You should have non-zero. Okay. If D16 and D26 is non-zero, then that bend twist coupling will be there. Okay. So that laminate will experience the bend twist coupling, which is an advantage in that case. Okay, whereas in other cases it's a disadvantage. Okay, so this is the thing. Now how do we get this? How do we get A16 and A26 equal to zero? Okay, I have not told you how to calculate A matrix, but I'm just telling you how to get A16 and A26 as zero. Okay, so for that, all layers for A16 and A26 equal to zero. Okay, all layers should be 0 degrees. All layers should be 0 degrees. Okay, or should be a cross ply laminate. Should be a cross ply laminate, meaning 0 and 90 combinations. Okay, or should be it should have for every layer, for every layer with theta orientation, every layer with theta orientation, we have another layer, with minus theta orientation, So all layers can be zero, or you can use a cross ply laminate, or for every layer with theta orientation, we should have another layer with minus theta orientation. So either of these, if you do, then A16 and A26 will be zero. Okay, if you calculate, I have not told you how to calculate, but when I tell you, when you calculate this, if you use any of these laminates, okay, meeting these criterias, any of these criterias, then you get A16 and A26 be equal to zero. So that is, that will avoid extension shear coupling. Okay, so this is the condition. Next is, how do you attendance? I don't need attendance, it comes automatically. No need to put in the chat your roll numbers, no need to put. Okay, so I just enable the chat, because if someone is not able to speak, then they can chat. Okay, so I don't need the attendance, it comes automatically. So how do you make B matrix as zero? Okay, if the laminate is, symmetric, if laminate is symmetric, then the B matrix is zero. Okay, if you use a symmetric laminate, we discuss this, what is a symmetric laminate. Okay, so if laminate is symmetric, then B matrix will be zero. Okay, B matrix will be zero. If you have B matrix as zero, then what are you avoiding? You're avoiding bending extension coupling. Okay, you're avoiding bending extension coupling. Okay, next is you have this D matrix. Okay, you want this D16 and D26 equal to zero. Okay, you should have layers are the plies or the laminas with 0 degree angle. Okay, or a cross ply, 0 or 90 combinations, and then or you can have ply with orientation of theta, ply with orientation of theta, another ply, of orientation of minus theta, which is placed, in other side, of midplane, at same distance, Okay, you can't just have a plus and minus theta somewhere in the laminate. It must be placed at the same distance. Okay, at the same distance. Understood this point? ply with orientation of theta, another ply of minus theta, which is placed in other side of the mid plane at same distance. Okay, so these are the 3 points which makes D16 and D26 equal to zero, and that will avoid bend twist coupling. Okay, so these are the requirements of the ABD matrix. Okay, to avoid coupling. So I hope you have got some idea of how the laminate is designed. Okay, mostly the laminates are symmetric to avoid this coupling. Okay, to avoid this bending extension coupling, most of the laminates are symmetric in nature. Okay, so these are some conditions based on which we decide the orientations. Okay, so we will continue in the next class. Any doubts so far?
Sir, apart from A16 and A26, is there any number tends to zero? Is there any cases like that?
Usually it will not be zero because these terms are not zeros. Okay, so it will not be zero because there will be some values here. When we look at the A matrix and B matrix, D matrix, you get an idea. Here, the main concept is to make these zeros. You are not much bothered about the other values. Okay, you are only bothered about A16 and A26 in A matrix. B matrix, all of the elements you are bothered, and D matrix only the D16 and D26. Okay.
Okay.
So this is what you are bothered about, but later we'll see in detail. We'll discuss how to calculate these matrix and then avoid all these couplings if required. If required, we can induce coupling as well. Okay. If application requires coupling, then we'll induce coupling. If application doesn't want coupling, then we'll remove the coupling.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, then we'll continue in the next class. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Excuse me, sir.